Right. Onwards. So, next up is Middle Earth: Shadow of Mordor. This one came out fairly recently. I love it. It's got some really cool new stuff that hopefully we'll start seeing more often in games. If you've played, I'm told it's somewhat similar to like Assassin's Creed in that there's some stealth elements. The combat is very similar to the Batman Arkham games, where it's basically you just kind of hit one button to attack, hit another one to defend, and it's kind of timing those things. The one thing that is a complaint some people have, and I don't really care, is that it really kind of doesn't have much at all to do with any of the lore of Lord of the Rings or anything. So it's more something that you just kind of want to play and have fun with. I'm going to start again at the beginning with the story mode, so you can kind of see the storyline. Once we get into it, since it'll be going through some of the tutorial stuff, it'll be explaining some of the mechanics, and I'll kind of go into why they're cool.
In the land of Mordor, where the shadows lie. It was here, on the slopes of Mount Doom, that the Dark Lord Sauron was defeated by a last alliance of men and elves. It is here that for 2,500 years the Rangers of Gondor stood watch, guarding against a nameless threat they had all but forgotten. And while the strength of Gondor faded, the power and the malice of Sauron grew in darkness. Has returned to Mordor. Shadow and flame have fallen at that gate, and no mortal man can stand in its path.
Is a perfect swing for killing chicken.
Wouldn't want to hurt you.
I'll take a lot more than that. Dear Hyle, the mighty chicken killer. Come on. Come on. Show your father what you have, huh?
You'll have to hit harder if you want to best your father.
Hard enough?
So much
Harry,
like
sir, don't forget to block.
Batman games.
You shall not forget to hit.
Stay alert, dear. Your enemy will not always
X
be
to
as
attack,
he
appears. And you just have to time this up right. Kill your son.
Easy, son. You're not a soldier yet.
I'll have your gun.
I'm all right.
My blade shall rest in your throat.
Dear Hyle, remember your training.
So once you knock the guy down, attacks you while doing that. Still kind of bad. But it won't then
lunge deep and cut deeper!
These orcs are much stronger than any we've ever seen.
They're not orcs, they're Oryks. They're far worse. There's too many. Go find your mother. Go find your mother. Keep her safe. I'll be right behind you. Go. Am I dead?
You are banished from death.
So you hold down right trigger for stealth. Let's not forget. You sneak up and kiss your wife.
Happy anniversary, my love.
Alien.
And that's the game.
This is beautiful.
So,
where did you find it?
No, I'm kidding.
I still have a few friends left.
I do like the way that they did these tutorials.
Did you talk to my father?
Yes, I did. And nothing has changed. He's still very stubborn.
I say we go anyway.
The Ahai will not come willingly.
There must be a better life than this.
Not now. But soon.
I'm just so tired of hiding here, Talion.
We must hide now, or we are both dead.
Put the sword down, Ranger. The Black Heart wants him alive. Take her.
Son, come right here,
Shirkushan.
Скушу. Там дьявол мой зак.
See for yourself. Now, do you believe me, Ranger?
What has happened to me?
You are banished from death. Cast adrift between the worlds of light and dark. Curse binds us together within the walls of Arda.
If what you say is true, then how do we break this curse?
We find the one who cast it on us. The Black Hand of Sauron.
Alright, so there's some of these towers here with these things where you go up and you reforge them as the elf wraith. Basically, it kind of they're kind of like the bonfires in the last game. You can fast travel to them, and they're where you respawn when you die, and they open up the maps and quests for these areas. So the spots that it's shown there are basically quests that we can go on. And collectibles and stuff like that. So one of the nice things is that there is no falling damage in this. You just run to a ledge and jump right off.
So, we missed one of you at Narcos, eh? An easy mistake to fix.
Alright, so we want to take these guys out quickly.
You will suffer for what you've done!
The Black Hand wanted them all dead!
Grab guys, hold on to them, and then press A.
Suffer me now!
Alright, I'm experiencing apparently the same issue that I had with Beyond Earth, where part of the screen is not showing up.
What do you know of the Black Hand?
So I will fix that in just a second. I'll probably have to go to window mode.
Made of thin air.
What more?
your slave I had. Swears he fought him. I sold him for a keg of grog to Gimu the slaver.
So this is one of the really cool things in this. There's orcs all over the place that you have to fight, but there's also captains, which are kind of like bosses. You don't know who they are, and they're kind of randomly generated. But when you interrogate those other orcs, you can identify who they are and learn information about them. So we interrogated that guy, and he told us about Gimub the slaver. And he also he lets us know how the power level, which is how strong he is. And then he's got a kind of story thing. Like I said, they're randomly generated, but they've all got like personalities. So it'll tell you that. And then you can mark him as a target, in which case it'll show you on the map where he is, so you can go and hunt him down. That one's a quest guy for the start, or for the storyline.
Not just where we have to go.
So he's always the same.
If one can trust an orc.
Trust has nothing to do with it. His thoughts cannot lie.
So we've got gold icons are story missions, red icons are power struggles. With the power struggles, the way it works is basically there's each of the captains has, like I said, they've got their power level. They will randomly be doing events in the world, and at some point in time the event will resolve. You can go in and try and stop that event from happening. But if it does happen, then their power will go up. So you're kind of always working against time, because the captains are going to get stronger. But at the same time, some of the events are like one captain might assassinate another one or something like that. So there's always this kind of change going on with the captains and their armies, which is really pretty cool. And then the white icons are basically just like side missions. And bonuses. So right now we've got two main storylines. We've got that slaver that we just learned about. We can go and fight him, or we can go and learn more about the Uruk society. So both of those storylines are available to us right now. You can see right now we've got the slaver mark, so he's off there in the distance.
The world has changed. Nothing makes sense.
Nothing has changed. This is how it will be. The future and the past are linked in darkness.
I don't understand why I'm here.
And I can't remember. Let's go find the slaver. His mind may provide answers.
So let me really quickly see if I can switch this to... If we go borderless, will that fix it? Yeah, that looks a little bit better. I think hopefully this should be working again. I had some difficulties with how the stream was set up for this game. Just waiting for a second to make sure that this comes back online, since there is a little bit of a delay.
It's amazing they don't make me a damn war chief.
I get it. You're unhappy about Ratbag. Just slit his throat already.
Thank you.
We need a real fight, so we can show the world we ain't mucking about.
Elves, dwarves, dragons, send them our way, and we'll make them pay.
All right. Looks like we're back. All right, so... basically what you missed was me coming over to this area, and I want to try and get down to that little white dagger icon down there to start a quest. But there's a couple guys in this area. There's a big, huge group of guys over there. Well, that's not a big, huge group, but there's a lot of orcs around here that
I'd like to see him do that to one in a line of real fire under the rest.
I don't want to get into another big fight with them. I just want to start this quest. So basically, this is a stealth quest. I want to kill. I want to kill 10 of these guys from stealth without being detected.
Many thanks, Ranger.
Thank you.
Gordon Master said I stole weapons from him. Filthy liar. He should be tossed into the...
We're free!
I saw the Tark scare Hawk so badly he dropped his axe. I gave the axe back by burying it in his skull.
And that's ten. So I get a bunch of XP and Mirian for that. And the quest basically just is then over. So that gives me more stuff to get, more health. The one thing that kind of irritates me a little bit about those is that even though I was being super stealthy the whole time, suddenly these guys all know that something horrible happened immediately afterwards.
Look, there's been a murder!
Three of these guys while I'm up here, so I'm pretty close to, so I'm right there. Here's where that Gim of the Slaver is. I want to fight him next, I think.
Seeing things.
Execution, because we know that what's his face. Oh, I forgot to actually wait. Did I get that? Oh, I've got two abilities to unlock. Take that one too. Good. So we know that Gimmick the Slaver is vulnerable to finishers, so having a finisher will be helpful in the fight against him.
Where was you earlier? Out hunting?
Nah, I was guarding slaves.
Artifact. So this is another thing that we can collect as a raid. It gives us experience thingies. So this is a silly little thing. You basically have to find the point, glowing point on the thing, and press a button. I don't know why
all
they
right,
added this. It seems kind
welcome
of.
Welcome to the Black Gate. You'll be building our watchtowers for us. Hard work will be rewarded.
Sir, do you mean hard work will be rewarded with a shorter sentence?
The traitors, the lot of you, murderers and thieves. When I say rewarded, I mean I won't throw you to the catacombs.
These men are not soldiers. They are not ready to die.
All things that live must die. Man alone faces the mystery of what is beyond death.
Thank you.
Up here somewhere. I think I want to try and take him down first. I thought I saw an archer here. Maybe I was wrong. Oh. Alright, I didn't know I could jump on that. Alright. Start the mission to kill this guy.
Human sight to track the Uruk. I see more than any mortal.
So go to Wraith mode, you can see all of the guys, and if there's a captain, you can press down on the right stick button to
slay
identify
the orc captain.
Him.
Cut off the head of the snake, and the body will wither.
Archers, I must take out the eyes of the camp.
So this is kind of like a little mini-mission. Even though we were previously in the camp, there's specific guys here. And we want to take out these archers because they will see us easier. There's a whole bunch of guys over there that are good for intel. One of whom is an archer, so I'm going to...
The stupid talks are afraid of the dark! Think how scared they'd be if they could see what's going on at Barra's door. Hey! They could run out of blood.
Let's see. Let's get intel on this guy. So he's vulnerable to ranged attacks. Ooh, so if I can get him with a headshot, that will kill him in one hit. He's terrified of another captain that we don't know yet, and he's damaged by combat finishers. He cannot be we can't sneak past him. It's good to know. He calls other units. That's why we had so many guys coming in that fight. Well, you guys didn't see it because I had video problems, but when I first fought this guy, there was like 20 orcs, and there was just like every time I killed a couple, three or four more came in. Alright.
Oh,
ones that have like yellow arrows over them are aware that someone's in the area. We want those to all go away, and then they kind of forget that there was ever even a problem.
What's all this about us leaving Udoon?
First off, Maddox.
If he comes back, I'll do it.
Stay on
rumors.
We're marching out
once the slaves
finish.
Don't
stink your burrowing. We barely punish you, Marshall.
For some proper battles.
Thought you were fast enough to escape, eh? We can imagine outrunning Udoon.
There's a fourth
came across those slaves. They tried to get away. But now they're gone.
They were made by slaves.
I see it. I don't know what you're doing. I think on him. That was close. And we killed him. So he drops a rune for our dagger. It's like the dagger. This rune lets us recover all of our focus and health when we kill a captain or war chief. So let's go ahead and put that on our dagger here. Right now I've only got one rune slot on my dagger. I can use those Marion points to upgrade that. So you kind of, in a way, want to, it kind of helps you to allow the captains to level up or power up, because then when you kill them, you get better runes.
So you didn't die 10 years ago.
I take it you did not come here to arrest me for treason, Captain?
You and I are all that remains of that garrison, Hugo.
Then why did you come here?
Looking for a slave that fought the Black Hand of Sauron.
More like ran away from him.
You know this man?
Of course. You're staring at him.
Where are the servants of the Dark Lord? Do you even know?
Perhaps.
This is no time to keep secrets.
I have been stuck here for weeks. Steady. Come to the outcast camp. We shall ask my scouts.
I'll be there.
So photo mode is, you know, you can take screenshots and stuff. I don't care. Runes, I got my rune. I'm still pretty badly injured.
The patrol found footprints behind the bushes, but no sign of that creepy little creature that's been
spoken about. Alright, there's an herb here, which will help my health.
You could throw a slave's head in the air.
Yeah, pipeweed. So that's pipeweed. You know, everything's got a story in this. Let's see. There's a guy coming here. No. Don't let him see me. I don't know how he's not seeing me. I don't know if he is seeing me. Oh, it's Captain. That's why.
Oh, have you lost count of how many times I've killed you? Let me remind you.
Captain's down in very short order, so he's giving
here
us a
is your end
for a bow, which gives us 11% chance to recover arrows or elf shot after something or other. After firing, so every time we shoot, we might get our arrow back automatically. Which is pretty nice. Alright, so we've got, oh, there's an artifact there that I still can get. Another little quest there. But there's a story quest here. Which we want to go and do. So we can say hi to Golem. Because, you know, he's in this game for whatever reason.
I bet the Lord Steward of Gondor is wishing he'd had a few more men at the gate. Not that it would have made any difference.
Like I said, the if you're someone who really, really cares about the story,
the first messengers have ordered to camp. They're reporting few casualties. We've struck a mighty blow against the forces of Mordor aligned against us. Let it be so, and not fool's idle chatter. Hagadorn, what news? They say we've won a monumental victory. You'll not be needing all that Athelis you've been grinding, my friend. If you need healing on this day, then more's the wonder. They say the Golden King has brought back a prize. Sauron himself, wearing the heavy chains.
I have lived half my life on the boundary of Mordor, thinking it was dead, never knowing the stories it held.
The Land of Shadow is awakening from a long slumber. It has many stories.
I hope the camp at the Maw doesn't join with us, because that'll mean more competition.
What sort of road it hides in the shadows, I wonder?
Something of great power has left its mark on him. I sense it.
And you feel he has answers?
For both of us.
We should find him, then.
It shouldn't be too difficult.
These tracks are not quite human, not quite beast.
Even more reason to investigate.
Die, worm!
Be wary. This creature leads us to peril.
Do you hear that?
Get behind you!
Just us!
Not even outcasts deserve this fate.
The chain of man seems to always end in shackles.
It would appear the creature is an apt climber.
The Hope slaves finally escaped. That was my camp. Their first attempt would have been met with blood. Cut their legs in the gate. They can dig on stumps.
I sense it knows more of me than I know of myself.
How could a rodent possibly know of a wraith?
It is somehow connected to me. I feel it.
Walker once, big as a house he was, and with flaming footprints in his way. Wasn't that the deal?
Walls are no obstacle for it.
Someone's sneaking about. This Uruk's dead!
Your creature's path is fraught with danger.
Keep your eyes on your work, then. Stop threatening me.
Our rations are down. It must be that sneaky rat. Looks like an ill-fed frog.
Disgusting beggar. Ain't fit to eat.
Runt's tracks lead us right into that Caddagor cave.
There! It's on the run!
Take yet another ability. Since I'm going to have to deal with some Caddagors, I might as well get that.
Thank you.
manner of spell is this?
A loss, Talion.
You remember?
A few broken images, yes. And now I wish that I didn't.
Your family was...
Perhaps that pain is what connects us.
Let's encounter!
Quick! It is escaping! They must have tracked the categories here.
Killed, you have to move in and press a button. But then you get to ride him around.
The creature lurks around here somewhere.
And they're good for if you just want to run into combat.
We must have it back. We must have it. Quiet. Quiet, precious.
Think you could sneak up on me so easily, eh?
No! No, don't hurt us!
Ah, stop it. What does he know of it?
Yes, we know his bright master came to us in our dreams.
Got a hunting challenge. So these are just some little things that come up. There's a survival challenge which involves getting different herbs, and then hunting challenge which involves killing certain animals. So here's a spider we need to kill, and you kill them by stepping on them. Some more in here. There's one. One more. There we go. So we got three spiders. Our other challenge is we have to find Nifrendil, which is the white four leaf. and then our next is to kill 5 flying creatures, which
the price for those who enslaved.
Right back!
Oh.
I'll take you one end!
Oh, this is the other guy. Nice. Get a bunch of wounds here. So we've killed a couple of captains now, which is pretty nice. Kind of need some help. Unfortunately, captains don't always die right away, but it's always interesting because when they come back, if they get brought back to life, a lot of times they will have scars from however you last killed them. Captains even... exactly what I was going to say. When a captain is killed, then there'll be an open spot, and new orcs can move into those spaces. So, if a regular orc ends up killing you, a lot of times they will become a captain. They'll get promoted to captain. Or not a lot of times, but every time, pretty much. Oh, hey, there's another huge group of them coming this way. Down this way? I can.
Men folk are weak and lack the stomach and muscle required for war.
Even if they did, they don't have the leadership to do much of anything.
Worst of them. What? Did you hear that?
So where am I here? I do want to unlock that tower.
You see nothing but Uruk-hai's growing in power.
What's gonna be the fastest way to get there? It doesn't involve running through a huge encampment of orcs. Oh, there's a couple guys coming this way.
Someone sneaking about.
I don't think anything was ever there.
I was hoping for a fight too.
Ah!
us have more. We've got a killer.
I don't like the sound of that.
Shit. I don't give a toss what kill.
I can't imagine where he went.
I'll kill him then.
What's he looking at? Yeah, so Uruk's not exceptionally smart. So the thing I wanted to get to was this tower. Climb up. Climb up this wraith. And if I do a reforge, that shows me on the map a new area. I can fast travel there, and there'll be missions in that area.